In general, I think historical artwork is a really fascinating and valuable resource for interpreting the ways in which ancient and medieval people perceived and experienced their world, and that definitely includes archery. But quite often, these artists were not perfect. They sometimes drew some very strange things. They were human beings, after all, and the point of their art was not necessarily to document their way of life for future generations. And there's nothing wrong with that. But it also means we have to be cautious when using artwork to justify any research, and take everything we see in context. Having said all that, and with no disrespect intended towards our ancestors, here are some interesting mistakes and general oddities that artists from bygone eras committed while depicting the use of the bow and arrow. Apparently, in the Middle Ages, right-handed people really hated left-handed people, but I didn't know they took it to the point of violence. Some artists made quite sure to depict this, such that everyone in one army was right-handed and the other side was all left-handed. Obviously, I'm kidding. In reality, I think this was more a matter of artistic convention and convenience, sort of along the lines of how actors never turn their back to the audience. These artists felt they should do the same thing with their characters. What is it with curved bowstrings? This is by far the most common outright mistake I've encountered. A string on a bow does not curve in an arc, not when it's braced, and certainly not when it is drawn back. It forms two straight lines, and yet people across multiple continents seem to have thought completely otherwise. In this image, the bowstring is not only curved, but the bow has the magical power to project the arrow with lethal force before the archer has even let go. It's not just a bow and arrow, it's a time machine. Finally, a straight bowstring. But his fingers aren't actually on the string. There's nothing really wrong with this drawing, I just think the expression on the doomed rabbit's face is kind of funny. One common assumption that people make is that artists drew directly from what they saw in the world around them. This is not necessarily true. Sometimes they just copied other well-known artwork. Copyright infringement wasn't really a thing back then. They threw in extra details here, subtracted them there, for us to determine what was real, what was embellished, and what was pure invention is often quite impossible. Finally, the familiar and ever-controversial question of, on which side of the bow did people put the arrow? At least in Europe, the artists were all over the place. It's possible to cherry-pick many images to support whatever side of the argument that you're on. This has been hashed out a lot by other commentators. However, I think I may have something novel to contribute to this debate. In many paintings that have multiple archers, what side the arrow is on seems to have been completely determined by which direction the character was facing. Regardless of the archer's handedness or method of draw, the arrow is always in the foreground, in front of the bow. This pattern is not in all images, of course, but it is alarmingly common. Here's my best explanation for this. Many painters might have drawn the archer and the arrow first, just so they could get the angle of the pose right. Then they did the easy thing and just sketched or painted in the bow behind the arrow. Now, if you don't believe me on this, here's some actual hard evidence. Other artists seem to have actually recognized their own inconsistencies. So they tried to surreptitiously paint the bow over a fully painted, fully detailed arrow. This is subtly evident in this image from earlier. The patch of arrow that has been brushed over with the bow even has all the reflections painted in. Hopefully this helps to demonstrate my point, regardless of whether or not you think that this particular arrow placement was right or wrong. Look at this painting. It's obvious that the artist painted the arrow first for both of the archers. Now, if this phenomenon is true, it might help explain one quirk of medieval European art. If coupled with the convention of not having the archer turn their back to the viewer, drawing the arrow first results in a rather unfortunate and common bias for Western archers using the Mediterranean release to be depicted placing the arrow in a manner more appropriate for the thumb release, despite the fact that both historical manuals and practical experimental evidence strongly suggest that they probably did otherwise. Modern artists are still making very similar mistakes. Just watch this cartoon parody of famous bow hunter Howard Hill.
And here, my friends, is the kid himself, Howard Hill, champion field archer and sharpshooter extraordinary. Here he shows how the novice usually places the arrow on the inside of the bow. It's fired from the outside, like this.
Now, obviously, this arrow placement would be just fine if it were a Japanese or Korean archer. But the point here is that the artists were not accurately portraying their subject matter. Artists often make novice assumptions, and they also often take the path of least resistance. Animating Howard Hill the way they did was convenient and easy, but it was not true to life. The artwork from ages past is fun to look at, but at the end of the day, we have to realize that it was exactly that. Art. It was created to serve a very specific purpose, and not necessarily to record life in photographic detail. Approach with enthusiasm, but also with caution.